allowing me to join the discussion. Malinaw na po yung paliwanag ni Congressman Rufus na yung ating konstitusyon ay hindi po nilalabag ng ABS. Yung kanilang application may be acted on by Congress. Pwede natin bigyan ng 1 month franchise up to maximum of 50 years. Yun po ang konstitusyon eh. Congressman Marcoleta lang po naman ang merong ibang impression eh. Ibang interpretation. And again, he cites the Constitution and a violation thereof in this particular issue. Can I ask the gentleman representing ABS, Attorney Bautista, a simple question? Pwede po ba? Andiyan po po niya? Andiyan pa po ba si Attorney Bautista?
Attorney Bautista? Andiyan pa po kung dito.
Nais ko lang liwanagan yung ulit-ulit na sinabi ni Congressman Marcoleta na meron siyang sinasite na tatlong batas na nagbibigay ng 150 years franchise sa ABS. Totoo po ba yan o hindi? You were not given a chance to answer that very clearly. I'm asking you now. Did you ever enjoy a 150-year franchise?
Hindi po. Never did.
Alam po po yun. Alam ko, and I agree with you. I just wanted that on record because Congressman Marcoleta was browbeating you. He was not giving you a chance to answer. Again, he's alleging a constitutional violation, but there is none.
Okay lang po yun. Okay lang.
Ang nakuha ninyong prakisa, kailan po ba? Yung latest?
79. I think Attorney Poblador can answer that question. I'm not sure when he got it.
I will answer it. 1995.
25 years.
Kaya nga po, paso na ngayon. Ngayong 2020, it is now terminated or expired. That's the reason why you are applying for a new franchise.
Yes, sir.
So malinaw po sa akin. Hindi lang malinaw kay Congressman Marcoleta. Unang-una, wala
Mr. Chairman, I object to the language being used by the gentleman from the party list, Buhay. He used the word browbeating, very unparliamentary language, and I move to strike off the record the remarks of the gentleman from Buhay party list, which have to do with Congressman Marcoleta in the sense that he demeans the character and person of Congressman Marcoleta.
I am not willing to be corrected by you because you also have
moved to strike, Mr. Chairman.
These proceedings. This is a congressional hearing. Mr. Chairman,
can you kindly suspend the rules, Mr. Chairman?
Suspended for a few minutes. Hearing resumed. Congressman Atienza, you have the floor. Pero remind ko lang po sana na refrain po natin na tukuyin yung ating kapwa. At saan para hindi po na maiwasan po natin na meron tayong arguments.
Mr. Chairman, may I know what the action of the committee is on my motion to strike off the record the unparliamentary remarks of Mr. Atienza?
At the motion by Congressman Dimulya. Any second?
Second, Mr. Chairman.
We object to that. We strongly object to the objection of Congressman Dimulya because he's also one who has been monopolizing this hearing. We are a 305-member Congress, and this committee represents the Philippine Congress. Kaya sana'y maging mas mapagbigay sila. Immediately magre-react siya ng ganyan. Nangangahulugan lang, tama po yung aking damdamin, na itong hearing natin ay hindi po natin inilalagay sa tamang direksyon. For us to be very parliamentary and strict about our language, I think you should also respect the feelings and sentiments of those who may not be agreeing with what you're saying, with what our colleagues are stating on
the floor. Mr. Chairman, I'm asking for a ruling, Mr. Chairman.
Hearing suspended again for a few minutes.
Session resume. Sa ating pong agalang-galang na Honorable Lito Atienza, sa ating pong elder statesman, ang hiningi lang naman po ng ni Congressman Rimulya ay yung pong wag po tayong magtukuyan dito sa loob ng ating hearing sa ating komite, at kinikilala naman po yung mga puntos na ni-raise ninyo. Doon po sa binanggit nyo, Honorable Atienza, tungkol po doon sa pagkakasunod-sunod ng mga nagtatanong o nagsasalita, pagpaumanin nyo, hindi po kami ang nagdedetermine yan yung nasa floor. everyone is welcome to attend the committee hearings. Ito po'y dinedetermine ng chairman ng Legislative Franchise Committee and the Committee on Good Government. So, Congressman Atienza, with your indulgence, I will rule to strike off the word probity and your reference to Congressman Marcoleta. Pero mali na po kayong magpatuloy sa inyong mga pagtatanong. So ruled. Congressman Atienza?
Mr. Chairman,
opo.
May we continue by way of manifestation? Dahil wala na po yung issue constitutionality nitong franchise application.
Opo.
Under the Constitution, it's very clear. No one franchise should be more than 50 years. They're not applying for a 51-year franchise. They're applying for a renewal of their 25-year franchise. So it is within the powers of Congress to determine this. And all I request, Congressman Marcoleta, who is enjoying, obviously, immense advantage in these hearings, because pag siya nagsasalita, hindi po niyo ini-interrupt, hindi po niyo pinipigil. Pag kami po nagsasalita, masyado kayong maigpit. Ngayon, gusto pa ninyong paalis yung aking ginamit na kataga. Wala pong masama rin sa probity.
Atienza,
kayong...
with your indulgence, Congressman Atienza, yung pong nangyari po kasi sa kay Congressman Marcoleta, yung pong mga oras ng iba ibinibigay sa kanya. Pero if you recall, Congressman Atienza, he never refers to anyone or any member of the committee. If I may, Congressman Atienza, you're raising a good point. Please continue with that. Kung maaari po sana, wag tayo ang mag-away-away, kundi po dun sa issue ng Constitution. Congressman Atienza, salamat po.
Anyway, gaya na sinabi ko po, tapos na yung issue sapagkat malinaw po ang saligang batas. Hindi po totoo na hindi pwedeng tumagal na mahigit 50 taon ang nag-e-enjoy po ng prangkisa. Pwede pong 100 taon. At kailangan korekin ko lang yung sinabi ni Congressman Marcoleta na nabigyan daw ng 150-year franchise itong ABS noong 1969. I'd like that question to be answered by him. Pwede po bang tanungin siya? Saan po ba ninyo nakuha yung impression na nabigyan ng ABS ng 150-year franchise noong June of 1969? I want that answer for the record. Dahil for the record, sabi niya, ang swerte naman itong korporasyon na ito. Nabigyan na ng 150, gusto pa ng additional. Mantalang marami kami question on the constitutional violation. Again, ako po yung sinundan ko itong hearing na ito. From the beginning, although ting mag-a-apply ako for interpolation, ako yung number 30, 34, ngayon naman number 17. Kaya pinagsagaan ko na. Dahil gusto ko namang marinig yung tinig ko. Kami po sa buhay party list, patas. Kami po ay nagtatanggol ng karapatan ng lahat upang magkaroon tayo ng mas maayos pamumuhay. Buhay party list kami. Anyway, to manifest my continuing strong sentiment on the continued allegation of violation where they have not proven anything up to this point in time. After the 7 hearings, wala pa po silang napapatunayan, humihingi sila ng records, meaning they're on a fishing expedition. Congressman Edsel Lagman talks from records existing. Congressman Rufus Rodriguez talks from records that he's holding. Yours truly, although I'd like to accept some of their allegations, kaya tinusundan ko, baka merong sasabihin talagang may katotohanan na ang ABS ay violate. Katulad po nung pagkakasoli sa kanila, ako po'y isa sa mga players ng EDSA Revolution. I am very well aware of what transpired during that period. How the Lopezes were deprived of their property, ABS network was taken away from them. Use whatever word you would want to use. Hindi nagbayad, ginamit ng administrasyon ni Mr. Marcos. Noong dumating ang revolusyon at nanalo ang taong bayan, isinauli yung kinuhang ari-arian. Ano pang pinag-aaralan natin? Ang tanong ko nga sa marami, kung kayo, yung bahay ninyo, inagaw ng isang opisyal ng militar under martial law, huwag na si Mr. Marcos, nawala sa inyong control, nawalan kayo ng bahay at ari-arian. Nanalo ang revolusyon ng bansa, naibalik sa inyo yung bahay. Pagtatalunan pa ba natin? O may television dyan bago, o meron dyan oven. Unfair, illegal, unconstitutional. Kaya po medyo nababagabag po naman ang inyong likod. Baka kung saan mapunta itong hearing eh. This is not an investigative court of law. Kaya yung mga hinihingi po mga dokumento, mga at mga preba to prove their points, para sa akin po eh, hindi tugma na dapat natin ginagawa. Ang pag-aralan natin, yung pakinabang ng bansa sa operation ng ABS-CBN. Ako po eh, hindi tao ng ABS at may reklamo rin po ako. Kapagkat nung kampanya ng 2016, ako po yung nagbayad ng mga advertising spots. Hindi, nananggap naman yung pera ko. Pero hindi po in-air yung aking spots. Kaya right after election, sinulatan ko ng formal ang ABS. Solid nyo yung aming binayad. You paid it before breakfast. It's one-sided. You charge us, we pay, and then you don't air, you have to give us back our money. Immediately, binalik po naman ang ABS at nag-apologize. Not, dahil talagang sumobra ang kanilang kinuhang spots, advertising spots, eh hindi nila na-air lahat. Ang aking pakiusap sa mga kasamaan, sama na po si Congressman Marcoleta, Congressman Barsada, Congressman Renuya, nakikiusap po sa iyo. Luwagan natin ang ating pananaw sa hearing na ito. Let us stick to the genuine issues of whether ABS has violated the Constitution or not. I've heard the Department of Justice, the Immigration, and one of the most prominent immigration commissioners we've had in the country is Commissioner Rufus Rodriguez. Siya po ang maraming report ng nagawa sa immigration. Narinig na rin po natin ang SEC. Wala pong violation sa PDR. E ngayon po, pinag-uusapan itong nagpas na sa prangkisa ang ABS sapagkat limitasyon daw. Daw, ah, yun ang interpretasyon. And I have to mention the name because talagang galing sa kanya. Yung kanyang allegation from the very start, ABS violated the Constitution repeatedly and one of which is applying for a franchise where they have already in operation beyond 50 years. But they have not gotten any franchise for 50 years even. Congress has the power to give a one-day franchise or a 50-year franchise. But the ABS has not enjoyed a franchise more than 25 years so far. So that I am constrained to clarify everything so that we may proceed with care. Kung gusto ninyong pagbigyan si Congressman Marcoleta sa kanyang repeated questioning on the constitutionality or violations of thereof. Okay lang sa akin. Total, ang boboto po dito noon, sa plenaryo tayong lahat eh. Yung boto niya eh, isa. Yung boto po ni Congressman Atienza, isa rin. And therefore, in the final analysis, eh, ito yung desisyon ng buong Kongreso. Subalit, huwag naman tayong magmukhang one-sided, biased, sa mata ng tao. Ang tanong po sa akin sa labas eh, ganun lang palagi. Kayo ba eh, talaga bang disidido kayong magbigyan ng pangkisa? Sabi ko, bakit ganun ang impression ninyo? Eh, napapanood po namin eh, yung paratang ng isa ay paulit-ulit na hindi binabago. Bagamat nagsasalita ng autoridad. Paniniwalaan ba natin yung kasama nating congressman who may not agree with the Department of Justice, with the immigration officials, with the Securities and Exchange Commission, eh yung citizenship issue, hanggang ngayon, issue pa rin sa kanila. Eh malinaw na malinaw po eh, dual citizen. Hindi naman dininay ni Mr. Lopez. I am an American citizen by virtue of my being born in America under American laws that makes me an American citizen. Ang reaction mo, ang swerte mo naman. At talagang swerte nga siguro. Kaya pag pinanganak kayo sa Amerika, eh, American citizen kayo. Pero ako, personal, hindi po ako naiingit doon. Hindi ko masasabing swerte kayo. Maraming problema Amerika ngayon. I wouldn't want to be an American citizen. But, Gabby Lopez is a natural born Filipino. But, My point is, why can't we accept the answers of the other side? Lest we be branded as biased and we are already decided on the issue. So to clarify it, Mr. Chairman, I have my highest regard for you. You are an old friend. I've been a member of this committee for so long, and you already are very familiar on how we have dealt with applications for franchises. Itong application na ito ay isinampa dito sa committee ninyo. Ang hinihingi ko lang, take better control of the proceedings, as this is not a committee of one congressman or two congressmen or three or four. This is a committee of 305 members of Congress, duly elected by the people. And the earlier we agree on this, isampan na ninyo sa plenaryo. Pagbutuan na natin, anyway, narinig na natin lahat ng argumento. Hahanapin pa ninyo yung pagkukulang ni Cory, pagkukulang ni, makakapagbigay po ng malinaw na sagot yan, Pangulong Cory. Under the Freedom Constitution, she was free to become a lawmaker and the chief executive. Alam ni Congressman Rufus yan. Binanggit nga niya, we were under a revolutionary government at the time. We had a suspended constitution. We had a freedom constitution. So I don't know what they are looking for. Even if they are able to find any fault, sasagutin lang po yan ng mga abogadong batikan. Wala na po yung taong nagkamali. Sino po ang ating parurusahan yung tumanggap ng benepisyo? Palagay ko hindi po. Usgahan natin ang ABS on the basis of their contribution to national development and, of course, the protection of the rights of every citizen and public service all the time. Yung po ang nakikita ng marami sa ABS. Kaya marami po tayong ipaliliwanag pag dito nagkamali tayo ng ating pamamaraan. I urge the chairman of both committees, Chairman Defensor is another member, another chairman of another committee, be more magnanimous and be more broader in your vision and appreciation of facts. Hindi yung gusto lang ninyo. Ano ang batas at ano ang katotohanan? Maraming salamat po sa pagkakataon, Mr. Chairman, and I trust that you will take heed to my admonition and my simple advice. Ituin natin ang pamamaraan sa committee ito. Salamat po.
Thank you, the Honorable Lito Atienza of the Boy Party List.
Pong Mike.
Yes.
May dadagdag lang ako, no? Atienza, simulat sa pool naman, ang ginagawa nating committees, binabalansi po lahat. Ngayon po, kung labas po, kung dating po sa inyo, ay one-sided, at tingin ko po, I beg to disagree, kasi tingin ko po, patas naman po, lahat po may chance magsalita.